Hi everyone, our subject today is knee pain in pediatrics. Basics, condition generally characterized by discomfort at the anterior aspect of the knee that is generally associated with activities, especially those involved running, jumping, and climbing stairs, has also been called miserable misalignment syndrome. Younger children are at a greater risk for fracture than ligament sprain because the physis growth plate are weaker than ligaments. How to approach to a child with knee pain after performing history and physical examination? Is there ligamentous instability present? If it is yes, differential diagnosis, ligamentous sprain or tear, anterior cruciate, posterior cruciate, medial collateral, and lateral collateral. If there is no ligamental instability, where is the site of the pain, by physical examination or by history? If it is anterior, if it is associated with pain at patella, if it is yes, either medial or lateral patella, differential diagnosis, patellofemoral stress syndrome, patellar subluxation, patellar dislocation. If it is superior patella, biparietate patella, quadriceps tendinitis. If it is inferior patella, differential diagnosis, patellar tendinitis, jumper knee, Sinding Larsen-Johnson syndrome. If there is no pain in the anterior aspect of the patella, differential diagnosis, contusion, fracture, Osgood-Skelter disease, infection, septic arthritis, osteomyelitis, ligamentous mesenchymal tear, osteochondritis, dissecans, and neoplasm. If the pain not specific localization, differential diagnosis, osteochondritis, dissecans, hips disorder, effusion, trauma, and other causes. If it is posterior, differential diagnosis, Baker cyst, medial mesenchymal tear, Robille immunization. If it is lateral, discoid lateral meniscus, iliotibial band syndrome, and fracture. If it is medial, differential diagnosis, medial meniscal tear or fracture. A history of twisting injury, a popping sensation, and rapid development of an effusion swelling suggest an anterior cruciate ligament injury. Children present later may complain of their knee frequently giving out. Evaluation of suspected anterior cruciate ligament injury should include X-ray to rule out associated avulsion fracture. Because anterior cruciate ligament tear are often associated with medial mesenchymal injury in children, referral for further evaluation, arthroscope or MRI is recommended. Biparietate patella is the result of secondary ossification center in the patella failing to fuse to the primary ossification center. Most are asymptomatic, but occasionally pain may occur with the sport, especially with jumping or climbing stair. Symptoms are usually unilateral, and the examination typically reveal pain at the superolateral pole of the patella. X-ray are diagnostic. Patellofemoral stress syndrome, also known as patellofemoral pain syndrome or patellofemoral dysfunction, compromise a spectrum of disorder characterized by anterior knee pain with no clearly definable cause. The term is typically applied to the pain syndrome experienced by adolescents. Often after a change in activity level, pain is vague described. It may be around the knee or behind the patella. It is exacerbated by climbing stairs, squatting, running, and after sitting with the knee flexed for the extended period. The pain is frequently bilateral, and examination may be normal or reveal medial patellar tenderness or pain with patellofemoral compression. Diagnosis is usually clinical. Significant pain or gardening with the attempt lateral or medial displacement of the patella, positive apprehension test, suggest a more serious disorder of a chronic or recurrent patellar subluxation or dislocation. Certain congenital conditions, high riding patella, shallow intercondylar notch, genovalgum deformity may predispose children to patella misalignment significant enough to produce recurrent subluxation or dislocation. Significant pain or gardening with the attempt to lateral or medial displacement, positive apprehension sign, suggest subluxation. In patellar dislocation, the knee is usually locked in approximately 45 degree of flexion. Sinding Larsen-Johnson syndrome is a apophysitis at the site of insertion of the patellar tendon into the inferior pole of the patella. It is an overuse syndrome that most frequently affects volleyball and basketball players. Pain is localized to the inferior pole of the patella and is aggravated by activity. Diagnosis is usually clinical. Patient with a similar complaint and tenderness over the patellar ligament near but not involve the body attachment are most likely to have patellar tendinitis, jumbar knee. Osgood-Skelter disease is an apophysitis at the site of the insertion of the patellar tendon into the tibial tuberosity. It is an overuse syndrome common in adolescent athletes who are undergoing a growth spurt. Examination reveals tenderness and swelling at the tibial tubercle and exacerbation of pain with the resisted knee extension. Symptoms are commonly bilateral, although one side may be more symptomatic than the other. Patients complain of worsening pain with flexion activity, running, jumping, kneeling, climbing stairs. Typically, X-ray findings are soft tissue swelling and occasionally avulsed bony spicules over the tibial tuberosity, although X-ray are not usually indicated when the condition is bilateral. X-ray should be obtained when the pain is unilateral, not located directly over the tibial tuberosity, and when the case are unresponsive to treatment. Mesenchymal injury are more common in adolescent than in younger age group. They are most commonly sport injuries due to twisting motion that occur when the knee is flexed and the foot is firmly planted on the ground. Medial mesenchymal tear are more common than lateral ones. The injury may or may not be evident acutely. Sometime may present later which complain of vague pain, recurrent effusion, stiffness, giving out, clicking, and sometime locking. Examination reveal joint line tenderness and occasionally a small effusion. X-ray are not helpful. MRI are preferred diagnostic entity. Osteochondritis dissecans develop after a small area of bone, most commonly in the medial femoral condyle, becomes avascular. The necrotic fragment with the articular cartilage overlying it, particularly or completely separated from the long bone. Patient complain of non-specific pain usually located around the patella and associated with activity. Effusion is sometimes present. Locking or popping can occur when the bone fragment completely separated into the joint space. X-ray with the notch view are helpful in diagnosis. MRI will better define the cartilaginous involvement. Discoid lateral meniscus is a congenital variant of the lateral meniscus. Patients typically present in late childhood or adolescence with a vague complaint of pain and an audible pop or snap with the flexion. Examination reveal a palpable bulge at the lateral joint line when the knee is flexed. Standing X-ray may show a widening lateral joint space, flattening of the lateral femoral condyle, or cupping of the lateral aspect of the tibial plateau. Iliotibial band syndrome is an overuse syndrome that causes lateral knee pain in runners. poorly localized knee pain accompanied by an abnormal hip examination, restricted or painful internal rotation, abduction or flexion suggest a primary hip disorder such as a vascular necrosis of the hip or slipped capital femoral epiphysis. Effusion are most likely to occur in association with the traumatic injury. Immediate development of effusion after an injury usually indicate hemoarthrosis. Effusion may develop slowly 2 to 3 days after an injury or may present intermittently owing to an intercapsular injury, mesenchymal tear, overuse, or rheumatoid process. Septic arthritis should be considered when the knee is acutely painful, warm, and swollen, especially if the patient is febrile or toxic. Immediate aspiration is essential when septic arthritis is suspected. Aspiration may also be necessary for diagnosis of chronic or recurrent knee effusion. Thank you for your listening.